insane. Absolutely insane to watch him play on this map. If anyone matches that score or gets close to that today in this match, I'll eat my words about the pop-off, I guess.
So I think obviously that was definitely a pop-off. And then even on the other side, there's two players. Oh, I think Birchman and someone else. It was Luskajuj. They got 400k on the map, which is actually really, really good. Problem is, they just get completely outshadowed by, I mean, what just happened. And going back into this, we got France protecting the DT3, banning the Hidden 2, and then Netherlands banning the No Mod 5. So they're going to look to ban No Mod 5, which means probably going to look to ban DT2.
Yeah. DT2, one of the customs for this week. I hopefully don't see that ban because it's a banger, but it's probably looking like it if we're seeing speed bans from the Netherlands.
Yeah, that was picked in the show match, so if you do want to see that, go check that out.
Yeah, very true. Actually, all these maps so far were. So if you are wanting to see any of these maps, go check out that show match. It was really cool.
You had the real 5WC player Tenacious in.
Yeah. All right. Still waiting on that second ban from the Netherlands. I'm not sure what else they'd really care about banning besides a DT2. To be honest, maybe something like the Nomad 2, because like you said, or like you mentioned earlier, it's a little inconsistent on that map. The stream aim that is in that one is just bonkers. It's crazy. Lots of overlapping patterns, lots of very tight circles. It is DT2.
Yeah, makes sense. And France, we can see the Hidden 1 ban from France. I hope to not see it. I really want to see this Hidden 1 being played because there's just bone sliders in it and I love it.
Yeah, that map is really cool. Really, really cool.
Yeah, but I mean, it might be looking like a Hidden 1 ban, but I mean, free mods also exist and it's Netherlands, so we could also see free mod 1, maybe free mod 2. Free mod 3 is also kind of funky, so. And we already know that Selena and UC2 are going to eat that map up.
Yeah. I think, yeah, it's probably either the Hidden 1 or a free mod, like you just said. Maybe, I think if I had to guess, it's free mod 2. Because that one's okay. I'm wrong.
That makes sense, though. I forgot that map existed.
Yeah, that's true. In this pool, this Nomad 6 is a lower AR, higher CS map. With some crazy spacing, some rhythm reading as well. Very popular disco map used in some tournaments in the past. I'm not going to be seeing that in this match. Maybe next time. We did see that in the show match as well. Last time I'll mention it, probably.
Probably not, but it's alright.
I'm going to try not to.
But, I mean, gimmick banning, France gimmick banning, and then, I mean, Netherlands doing the speed bans, but can't ban all the speed, unfortunately, because DT3 is still open. Although it's not 100% speed, it's a bit of a finger control speed mix, which, I mean, I think is still fine for going into Netherlands.
Yeah, indeed. All right, so France with the first pick. Let's see what they're going to want to go into.
I just want this song that's in the background to go away.
It's not that bad.
I don't enjoy it at all.
I feel like we just heard it too many times, yeah?
Maybe. That might be it. Nomad 2. All right. So
I'm excited.
Yeah, we did not see this in the show match, so this is one of the first maps that will not be repeat. Two things about this map. One, this was an OWC map last year in the round of 32 or 16, I do not remember exactly. And 16. Two, there is a lot of aim into this map, but not jump aim. There's flow aim that is very, very relevant because the flow aim in this map is very difficult. I think it's arguably harder than the actual tapping.
Because I agree.
It's only 185.
I agree completely. Like, there's, I guess there's like a baseline stamina check in this map, because there's like some 32 streams, but the aim is just so, so brutal. And it's note lockable too. Very, very easy to just trip up once and then completely fall apart. I'm excited though. Azer Nomad 2! Azer Nomad 2! You've never seen it before except in OWC last year.
Yeah. And for the side of France, I mean, I think these rosters look pretty good. We got Biotic, we got Druxarda, we got Cumanian, we got Mize. You know, those very solid two at the bottom of your screen. And then if you want to take away the Netherlands side, Rupa.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, right now we've got UC4, UC6, UC8. I'm going to go look for real names because I want to try and call them by things, not just the UCs.
So UC1 is Oob.
Yeah.
UC2 is UC2. UC3 is Celine. UC4 is XD.
Oh, okay.
UC8 is just Lucan.
All right.
UC7 is Nibble. And then UC6 is Unveiled Golem.
I forgot there was a command for it. This is so awesome.
You can also... Here, I'm going to give you a little hint. You can go into the 5WC roster history street and they're all right there.
Oh, true. That's so true. This guy's a genius. All right.
Yeah,
so
you don't have to go back and forth through the Twitch chat button.
Yeah.
Command.
Much appreciated. Much appreciated.
Yeah. All
right. So we are going to be seeing Celine. We're going to see XD. We've got Just Lucan. And we have Unveiled Golem. There's Celine. We see Celine on this map. Wow, that's crazy. That's so crazy.
So you remember what I said about France's really good things that they should do?
Mm-hmm.
How they should pick maps that UC2 is not going to be on?
Yeah.
Yeah, do you see UC2 on that Netherlands too? Because I don't.
I don't see him.
I think this is really good for France.
This is what they have to do. They have to dodge UC2 as much as possible. And this is the perfect way to start off and do that.
Yep, and I mean, this map is just hard throughout the entire map. There is no easy part in this map.
No.
And I mean, this beginning section, I mean, you can see there's accelerating, decelerating streams. And then I guess this is like a little bit of an easier section, but Biotic and Q-Mania missing pretty early. 3-minute map though, with 2,000 combos, so we'll see if that ends up mattering, and everyone's holding pretty strong right now.
Yeah, no major breaks at the start. People still trying to get in the rhythm. It is the first map of the match after all. One break from Unveiled Golem, actually. UC6. It's going to matter a little bit, but we are getting into one of the longer stream sections. So we'll see. He's able
sliders
to recover. No other breaks.
See if these sliders could be a bit tricky. You know, we get some slider spam going in the stream, and actually we have Lucan missing as well.
Yeah.
And
another break from them.
France is holding. And ooh, we see another miss from XD. And it is really just Celine right now versus four whole FCs on the side of France with Golem recovering just a bit, but
yeah, really big combos on the side of France, and this score is going to blow up fast because the scaling score is going to start to come in.
Oh, and this is what we're talking about right there, with the chain missing.
Yeah.
But
still two and one big combo to just the one on Netherlands.
Ooh. Q-Mania missing. That wasn't an FC, but it was basically an FC, but I mean, it's not mattering because the trades are being matched on the other side. It's just Druxada and Mize. And,
Oh, boy. Okay. Well, now it's 1-1, and combo lead is actually just barely on the side of the Netherlands. So that score lead's going to start to shrink. If we see a break from either of those FCs, it's really going to matter a lot.
And who'd have thought that Celine's still holding? But, I mean, we got Maya still. And 150 score lead, this is still definitely doable, especially with Biotic and Q-Mania actually chain missing. But Celine missing, Golem missing as well, and there's just nothing to match Mize right now. If he holds on for just a tad, there's only like 600 combo more or less in this map. If he can hold for another 300, I think he's secured it for the boys.
Wow, look at how comfortable that stream aim is. just dipping below 99 now.
Oh.
Oh my gosh. Still, what an insane score for Mize. Pretty much single-handedly making sure this point does not flip over to the Netherlands. Celine tried to put up a really scary score, but Mize held on a lot longer. Wow. Nice first pick from France. Even as the Ghost 2 memory overlay breaks, it's still going to definitely be a France win, taking their own first pick of the match. Very nice. Very nice by them. Crazy score from Mize. Crazy score from Celine. Really, really nice scores all around, actually. No major, major issues. Probably a little bit of a nerves issue for DC's 3 and 6. But yeah, it's just super easy to chain miss on that and drop a ton of score.
Yeah. Something, I think I'm gonna combat you on the nerves for Celine. That person has 6 badges. I don't think Celine knows what nerves are.
You're right. Well, you might be right. It's the first map of the match. In what is probably their biggest tournament. I don't know what all their badges are exactly, but this is a World Cup. This has a lot more weight than just your average badge tournament does. So
that's true. I think, you know, I mean, Celine having 2 5K badge tournaments, plus usually country-based tournaments have a relatively worse team than open international tournaments just because you're country locked. So I don't know. It depends. But anyways, that's besides the point. France carrying their own point. Netherlands gets to decide what they go into next. Hidden 3 is available to them. Don't imagine them going into it right away. Hidden 1 is open. All the free mods are open. They have plenty to choose from.
Yeah, plenty indeed. Probably Hidden 1? I don't know. I'm not sure. I'm really not sure. They have a lot of things that they could go into right now. I think it's going to depend on how they're feeling right now on this given day.
Yeah, I don't think the pause for Netherlands choosing is I don't know what to pick. I think it's okay, we know what to pick. What do we pick? Mm-hmm. And they're slamming the Hidden 3, which
they're going right for their protect.
Yeah, maybe it is a they don't know what to pick then if they're immediately going into it. Maybe they're not confident that they can win some of these free mods or maybe even the Hidden 1. I mean, yeah. maybe France traumatized them, you know, with their last match. Maybe they're just taking things safe, which not necessarily a bad thing, but
I can't say I love this pick right now, though, because it's right after the really flow aim focused Nomad 2, and there's a ton of flow aim in this map. That's the hardest part of the map. There's lots of snappy bits as well, but like it's still a tapping focused aim map. So we'll see if that Nomad 2 for France helps them be more ready for this Hidden 3. But I mean, it's not like the Netherlands is going to struggle on this map. Yeah, well, it's just a matter of following the flow of the match. I have to see. Not a bad pick. I'm sure they know what they're doing. They definitely know something that I don't.
But UC2, Celine, good luck. We have a Nuage coming in, Mize, Dracals, and Draxarda, pretty core state hidden staple for this team. But yep. I mean, the biggest concern is just, this is one of those maps where if one player pops off, they can single-handedly win their team the map. And I think that is what we're going to see here. I think that if UC2 and UC3, maybe both of them, maybe one of them, if they don't pop off, I think they're going to lose this pick.
Yeah, I agree. I'm expecting a better overall team score from France, but I don't know if that's going to be enough. We'll have to see. Hidden 3, a little bit of a build up at the start.
Yeah, this really, combo really is very important.
Mm-hmm.
If you miss here, that's not setting a pace for good because this map is not comboable. And you need to get any combo you can. Accuracy is completely relevant. With Draxarda missing there and Mize missing there too, that's not what you want to see. I do want to point out that Nuage has an SS and no longer has an SS.
Oh, come on, man.
Before I got that Senzel.
It's the intro. Why even mention it?
I don't know, man. It's pretty impressive, though, still. I mean, 200 combo in is, for this kind of map, is pretty impressive for an SS. So we'll let him keep that. I mean, you can see the accuracies on everyone else. Accuracy is actually benefiting France quite heavily. Not heavily, but I think it slightly benefits France. And...
yeah, but what's really gonna start to matter is who can combo these, or even who can chain miss them the least. Because missing one or two notes to break combo won't be the end of the world, but as you, that's not what you want to see. Two players, one on each side, chain missing. Oh my gosh, yeah.
And
first key eye of the map.
Oh, but that's like, oh, it's so weird though, because Celine missing, but the entirety of France missing, and I mean. This is kind of what we just talked about. I mean, UC2 is just...
it's that one guy.
It's the one guy, like...
yep. Okay,
you
well...
you can't... I mean...
yep. It's this is one of the maps in the pool that really, really caters to pop-offs. If you can get one person, one of your star players, to just go off on that first section, it's the map's over. Like, it's already almost a 250,000 score gap just because one person held. Essentially just because that one person held.
Celine
still has a good score.
We have a bit of slow section here. So, I mean, people in France can get a little bit more combo, but, I mean, UC2 is going to need a miss. And this is just what, I mean, Netherlands has been doing the entire tournament. It's just picking maps where they can... these one, two players can absolutely beast mode the entire, I mean, the map. And that's, like I said, that's what they've been doing. And unfortunately, it's for France. I mean, it's working. And it's, right. I don't know if it's over yet, but I mean, it's getting there pretty quickly. And as soon as we're done with these little funny sliders, we're just going to get straight into it. And here we go. We'll see if all eyes on UC2 right now. If UC2 misses, then France has a chance. But with these, but Nuage missing. Dracula's still holding, but I think it's becoming out of control. What is UC2 doing? UC2 is still going mode. Not missing whatsoever. Just holding until the end. The act drops are not mattering. We might see a million team score or a million score from UC2. What is he still going?
How is he still comboing this map? This second section's even harder than the first one.
And, I mean, the hardest part of the map is already out of the way in UC2. Absolutely.
Nah,
we
no
talk
way.
About the best players in the world for 5 digits right now. But I think people just overshadow UC2 because of how good Celine is. UC2 is the best hidden player in the entire world. UC2, what are you doing? You absolute monster.
You don't FC that in tournament. You don't. I don't care who you are. You don't FC that map. There are 4 digits who would call that their best score in tournament. There are 3 digits who would be shocked if they got that score. You don't just do that in the grand finals of a tournament. I'm in shock.
I gotta give props to France, though. France kept that close despite that happening. Those are some pretty good scores on France, let's be honest. I want to make that clear before France had very good scores. It just doesn't matter. Their scores are completely irrelevant. Completely irrelevant.
I'm in shock. I have no words to describe that. I just was... Zef Kiel got 700k on that in the show match. I was shocked when I saw that. I don't know what to say. A full combo on that hidden 3.
Yeah,
best score we've seen all tournament? Can we call it now? It's probably a little early to call, but I kind
of
don't care.
At this moment, that is by far, absolutely by far, the best tournament performance we've seen this tournament. It's not even close. I don't know what number 2 is, but it's not even close to that.
Jesus.
Maybe Zef Kiel. Literally maybe Zef Kiel on the same map.
Yeah, and you come in and do that on your first map of the match. Like, I don't know. That's insane. What a madman. Yeah, absolutely insane score. Well played.
Before that map, I was going to call a Selena UC2 FC, but I was just like, nah, I think the map's too hard. I think they're going to get, like, maybe Zeph Kiel score a little bit above Zeph Kiel score, but I don't see an FC. Yeah, I should have called that because I should have just trusted my gut because, I mean, that was...
That's I mean, easy too.
That's I don't know why they protect that, I guess.
Yeah. Well, that's a... You know what? That could... They just made a statement. I can see first picking the map now because they just laid down the law. You do not want to play against UC2 today.
Yeah.
DT3. But... Okay, DT3. How do we recover from that? How do we go on the next map?
The thing is, the problem with this map comparatively to the other speed map that they picked, Nomad 2, not speed map, UC2 can play this. So, UC, because it's not as tapping intensive. So, I mean, unfortunately, you failed to get UC2 out of the map. I'm not saying that this is a loss for France by any means. But, unfortunately, not able to.
That's, you know, almost a little scary that UC2 can play this if France is picking it. If they're going along the mindset of we need to pick maps that we can get their two top players out of on, if they didn't think one of them could play this and now he's in on it, that doesn't speak well for the rest of France's picks. Like, granted, that's overthinking a lot. If they're not going that deep, then sure, go off, but... We'll see. I'm scared to see if UC2 could play this as well as that in 3.
I want to make something clear. UC2 can play this, but I don't... UC2's accuracy, you'll definitely be able to see, is not... Yeah, not accuracy.
Mm-hmm.
And, I mean, these beginning act drops don't... You gotta wait a little bit before the map can actually start going, but... I mean, we have we got Offmoon, we got Dracols, Mize, Q-Mania, and this is a pretty solid speed roster. I think we swapped one person out from that Nomad 2. But, I mean, Offmoon and Dracols missing pretty early with the 4-3 now still holding on the side of Netherlands. It is, I mean, it's... Yeah. When we did the roster reveals showcase, we talked about the two best duos in the entire tournament, Mize and Q-Mania, and we're seeing it in play now. Mize and Q-Mania versus UC2 and Celine. I mean, that's what we're seeing right now.
Yeah, Mize breaks. Oh my, I was going to point the accuracy out, but I think combo matters a lot more now. It's 2 FCs to 1 right now. Netherlands is going to slightly pull that over. It's going to go fast now that Q-Mania breaks.
Yeah, and everyone missing on the side of France. And I mean, just UC2 and UC3, I mean, they're getting to the stage where accuracy is almost completely irrelevant. And I mean, UC2 is showing it. Problem is with bad acts like this is it makes the score, like for the good act, swing over very quickly. So they're gonna need to be very careful with these misses from UC4 and UC8. And I mean, Offmon just keeps missing with the side of Dracols, and I mean they're just kind of not.
Both players broke. Wait, I didn't even see that happen.
Yep,
wait.
And look, that's what I said. Broke. The accuracy is coming into play now. The combo game, you actually need a combo game, and because. The accuracy is not the greatest on UC2. I mean, Mize is single-handedly able to swing this over with the backing of Dracols. And, I mean, UC4 and UC8 are not enjoying this map at all. It was just UC2 and Celine. And with... I mean, if your two powerhouses miss on that, then that's just game over. And, I mean, that's just what we see in Point to France.
Yeah. This is going to be the story of the match. Can France's overall better team score top the Netherlands' two-star players? And it's another good pick, really smart pick from France. All four players really, like, or at least three of them getting really good scores. Offman was not that bad. He did his job. He beat two players on Netherlands. And Mize, really nice score, only one miss. Highest act in the lobby by quite a big margin. Very nice score. Following up that Nomad 2 score as well.
Yeah, I mean, tapping, Mize, they kind of go hand in hand, and... We haven't seen any breakpoints yet, so we'll see how long that can we keep that train going. Netherlands, able to pick. Can you remind me? I unfortunately cannot remember. Is double picking allowed?
Yes, double picking is okay. Allowed.
Hidden yeah, one, so they, potentially.
Hidden one. You know. Hidden one. Hmm. After that one. Map, I'm not sure. I don't know if there's really a way to like follow up that DT3, because that thing is unlike pretty much everything left in the pool. not sure. Maybe it is just Hidden One. Try and get back onto the hidden side of things where their roster just really seemed comfortable. We will see possibly a Fremont 2 as well. I expect to see that as well, at least at some point in the match. We'll probably see all three Fremonts. I would assume we'll see all three Fremonts. Both teams are not against playing those. I'm excited to see Fremont 3 especially, because that is a map that practice will definitely show on. It is not the type of map you sight read at all.
Yeah, Fremont 3 is arguably in early round could have been pulled for a Nomad 6. It's super funky. It's got the finger control and everything else, but I think I predicted correctly on this one, as well as my good old friend Lupa, and it'll be the bone map, the dog bone sliders.
I like this map. This map is cool.
I love this map.
I like this map a lot. Really? Okay.
Absolutely my favorite map in the pool.
That's a good choice. That's a good choice. I like the way, I think it was, I don't remember who it was between Miles and Tycani, who described it as mech tech and like as mechanics focused tech. And I am absolutely going to use that term from now on, because that's a perfect way to describe a map like this. I think that's what Hidden needs a lot of the time. Like that awkward aim that we used to see in years past was kind of like, not really the best tech for, or best choice for Hidden. I think we've started to move away from that, and I like that. That's usually now in like a Fremont 1 type of slot. But now Hidden 1 is starting to get some more creativity and not just a Nomad 1 with Hidden slapped on it, and I'm really liking that, especially with this pick for this round.
Yeah, I know this tournament specifically, Maxi, I believe, is the head puller, and Maxi pulls are always super oriented on unorthodox goal like ones in terms of Rock and Hidden. They're not usually just base aim. There's usually something else to them, which, I mean, I think base aim maps are pretty boring. I think most people would agree with me. But, I mean, this Hidden One, I mean, it's got, if you listen to it and you're just like, oh, it's just tech map, that's not completely accurate. Mm-mm. This map has aim. It does have some tech elements with these like really weird bone sliders, some fast sliders, but I mean, it's got some aim to it too. So, and we see the gamers in, and UC2, UC3. Oh boy, we'll see if the man, the myth, the legend, UC2 can do it again.
It's also a really short map too. Yes. It's under 2 minutes, so you have to be able to adjust to these patterns really, really quickly. Otherwise, you're going to be missing out on a lot of score.
Yep.
Smaller CS makes this a lot harder as well, CS5.
And Halfmoon and Mai is actually missing super early, but I mean, UC4 and UC8 trading it, and I mean, Nuage holding it strong, but I mean, Nuage is going to need a little bit of help, and that break from Celine right there does a bit of work, but I mean...
It's a slight combo to France right now, and like we said, the map is short, so we're third of the way in. Getting into the funky sliders and tapping patterns right now. Wow. And Celine's accuracy. Wow, yeah.
Yeah, Celine, I believe, like on a 100 or one miss right now.
Oh, new age breaks just before this Ki.
Yeah, that's not ideal, but I mean, Athlon holding a bit and Druxarda trying to do some supporting here. And the UC4 and UC8 are struggling a bit, which is really helpful to France. And it's actually going down, but with Offen missing and Droxarda missing, it is UC2 doing things like full comboing maps and carrying their team. I guess I'll put my team on the back, says UC2. And I mean,
like, another one? Can we see another one in the hardest SR pool that 5Digit can offer?
No.
I'll curse that every day of the week. That stream is really hard.
Nuage hit that stream, but I mean, I think it's too late now, unfortunately.
Yeah, it's just too much score gap. UC2 held on for more than long enough. Yeah, very nice score.
And wow. I mean, 200K, I mean, that was pretty close for France, but I mean, the UCs just won them that point.
It's not bad. It's like when you see the score difference from France, maybe on the surface 200K might seem bad, but looking at the overall team scores, it is once again France having a like 3 to 4 really solid scores, and then the Netherlands just having one or two people who go crazy and make up for the fact that the other two people are struggling a little bit.
This Netherlands performance and how they operate their team is exactly why the majority of the casters on the prediction stream did not put them first, is because we were all like, you know, UC2 and Celine will be completely fine, but we don't know how they're gonna, you know, how they're gonna fare in like grand finals, you know, the other six, right? Well, that doesn't matter if they FC everything. So
that's true.
And that's kind of what's been happening.
Yeah. The issue is, do the Netherlands run out of maps to put UC2 in? Because France is obviously going to pick everything that they possibly can that he's not in on. But if are there enough maps to get 7 points out of that? Or will Celine be able to step it up enough to make up for the fact that UC2 can't on some maps?
I don't think there's that many maps that UC2 can't play, and that's kind of a problem that, I mean, every team has going into the Netherlands. At some point, you're just gonna, as France, you're gonna run out of picks to keep UC2 off of, and you just gotta pick just things that you're good at and just completely ignore what happens on the other side. And, you know, you might win some, you might lose some, but I think, France still's got quite a few good picks. I think that the free mods are very even in this match. Mm-hmm. No mod 3, no mod 4. I think those are very France favored. And boom, I've said it right there. No mod 3. They've super favored this map, this mod slot, the entire tournament. Picking it, I think, every single round. Protecting it quite a few rounds. And I mean, no reason for them to change it now if it's worked every time.
Yeah, I like this pick a lot. I think this is really, really solid. And this is going to give France's full team a time to shine too. Because they've got both pop-off players and players who can have good fill scores on this. This is a good pick. And it's ice cold too, so it's really comfy style alt. It's extremely hard, don't get me wrong, and it's a draining map to play. But the patterns feel a little bit more comfortable than some of your alt maps, like that one last round.
So there is a good and a bad thing going for France right now. The good thing is you're very good on ult, consistent as a team, and we've had some pop-off performances. The bad thing is this is Celine's best skill set, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
So we'll most likely see, don't be surprised we see an FC from Celine or a one miss.
I find it hard to believe, going into this match, I didn't expect anything to be FC'd. Because this pool is just all kinds of hard. It's 6.8 to 6.9 stars. I think it's 6.9. And it feels harder than that in a lot of these maps that have been played already. But after seeing Hidden 3, anything is possible. All expectations that I have had are gone, thrown out the window. Let's see an SS from Celine, yeah? Yeah? Can I see
an
SS?
It's not happening.
I know it's not happening. But
yeah,
I an hour or two ago I would have called you crazy for thinking she can FC. Now I would believe it in a heartbeat.
UC2 is pretty comfortable on the skill set, but Golem hopping into the match, I think their third best player on this team, arguably. Golem has definitely showed up this tournament. I honestly did not know anyone on Netherlands with the exception of, you know, the gamers. Mm-hmm. And then, I mean, some of these players on Netherlands, like Golem and XD, and I mean, I've just been absolutely showing up. I mean, Golem, I believe FCing the Hard Rock 3 last week, not once, but twice. That is crazy. But I mean, we're getting into it. We've got, just kind of who you expect. Draxarta, the all-rounder. Mais Humania, the, you know. And then we got Nuage with, you know, who you'd expect on the Netherlands.
Yeah. Yes, sir. And then we've got XD and Golem as well, like you already mentioned, as well as the two standout players for the Netherlands. Lots of flowing focus in this Nomad 3. The spacing changes a lot, so if you're not ready to have that kind of cursor control in these Ki sections, you're going to be caught off guard quite a bit.
Yeah. We talked about like a comfy mapping style. We can also talk about like the base like difficulty settings for the map. I mean, CS 4.2, AR 9.4, that is super comfortable for most players. So, I mean, the patterns are really going to be the only thing that people might have trouble with, which, I mean, there's a bit of a easy section here, I think. And then, like, right after the slider a little bit, we get to, like, one of these sections, and then we get straight into the meat and juice of the map, and we'll see. And, I mean, it's dead even right now. Oh, but UC4 misses right before the breakdown of the section, and I mean, it's going in favor of France so far.
Yeah, another break from them, but that's not going to change the flow of the points just yet. That break will, though. That was one of the few FCs left for France. It's now 3-2, almost 3. Score lead very, very tight. Going to swap over to the Netherlands as long as they hold through the snap section.
The accuracy, though, I think the accuracy might be preventing it from going over that quickly. It does eventually go over, but...
Oh, yeah.
I mean, Nuage and Mize have to hold, because I don't imagine UC2 or Celine missing on these kind of maps. And, I mean, you might start to worry a bit, but, I mean, Q-Mania's got some backing combo, but we need Golem. I mean, UC2 or Celine to miss, or France even get a remote lead here. But, I mean, it's going to stay pretty close until then. Maybe we see a miss from one of the recovering combos from... XD, but Nuage missing is absolutely detrimental for France.
Yeah, that's one of the players they really needed to hold. Those three scores on the Netherlands now are going to start to accumulate points way faster. These are crazy scores, by the way. The consistency from pretty much everyone in this match is insane.
Yeah, I mean, we see some misses from the bottom two or Netherlands, but Q-Mania and Mize just, they don't have enough combo. They need a miss because, and Q-Mania missing, and Mize missing as well. And I think that might be it. I don't see Celine or UC2 missing on this map.
Yeah. And now we're at this point, 300k score, there's no time. Now it's just eyes on them to see if we'll add some more FCs to the list.
Yeah, there is 200 combo left in the map, and that is just not enough. UC3 missing, that's super troll. But, I mean, and UC2 missing, so we won't see an FC, unfortunately, but those are absolutely disgusting scores from UC2 and UC3, and even unveiled Golem with Q-Mania, Mize, and Nuage again. And, I mean, this one was not a two standout performance. France better team score. This was a straight up Netherlands had a better team score than France.
Yeah. Golem struggled a bit, but like
towards the end.
Or sorry, not Golem. XD struggled a bit, but yeah. Golem really, really popped off on that map, even beating I guess three or two players on the side of France. I thought it was three. But yeah. Oh my gosh, a slider break from Celine. Okay.
Oh, okay. Yeah, unfortunate, but Celine actually getting the better score over UC2 because of that accuracy.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, that's a break point in favor of Netherlands.
Yeah, that's scary. That's pretty scary. Really? Yeah, that's it. Let's see if Netherlands can...
Yeah, that's just it, yeah.
...consolidate this point, because if they can, then we're... looking good to avoid a tiebreaker, but if they end up making a misplay, maybe thinking that they're more prepared for something than they am.
So, call me crazy, but I don't think France wants to go to tiebreaker.
No.
I think France loses tiebreaker 100% out of 100%.
Yeah, you do not want to go to tiebreaker, this specific tiebreaker at least, against Celine.
Because it is, yeah.
It's very, very well-rounded in terms of skill sets, but the alt sections, like, they come up a lot more than... Or, like, the alt patterns come up a lot more than other patterns do. And like we just saw, her level of comfort on that is insane. So yeah, you want to avoid that at all costs.
There's, which will... Yeah, I mean, the thing is with this tiebreaker is, I mean, you basically nailed it on the head. It's just a variety of skill sets. I mean, UC2 and Celine could literally play everything. I don't know. Like,
this is tough.
France, they need, I honestly think it is imperative that they get this next point, even though it's Netherlands pick. They cannot afford to go down.
I agree. I think that momentum in this is going to mean a lot. A lot. Like, a comeback in this type of match, with the way these teams are matched up, is even more unlikely than I think a typical match would be, just because of the way things are in terms of players. We are going to see Freebod 1, though. Aim-focused, fast jumps, lower AR.
Yeah, it's a bit old school. It's a little under 4 minutes. And I do believe there's like at least one break in this map, but I mean, France has got a pretty solid free mod roster. But yeah, I mean, the UC2, Celine, and Golem squadron is kind of hard to overcome.
It's hard to overcome, but I think this is one of the maps they can definitely
doable,
do.
Doable, though, yeah.
Yeah, this doable. This is one where they really, really have to have a good performance, or at least have one person who can match one of the crazy scores on the Netherlands, because this is like you mentioned at the start, the free mods are all going to be pretty contestable for both teams, and it's important that they get back on the board, back in the swing of things.
Yeah, we have Nuage staying with Draxarda. I'm just assuming those two are going to slam the hidden. I don't think we're going to see a hidden hard rock on this team for France. I don't 100% think we're going to see it for Netherlands either.
I don't know. Hidden hard rock on this is pretty uncomfortable from what I remember, but I also could be super wrong about that. It's a jump map. That's not my thing. That's just not my thing. I don't know. It's also higher AR than I remembered. I thought this was AR 9 or 9.1. I'm misremembering. 9.3.
So this is the loved map, if I'm not mistaken, and there's a million, trillion, billion versions of this map, and all of them are played at tournaments. And all of them are AR 9, with the exception of this one.
Gotcha, okay.
So that might be why.
Mm-hmm. Alright, good luck, have funds have been said. Let's see where the mods have landed. Three hiddens on the side of France, one hard rock, two hard rocks and two hiddens on the side of Netherlands.
Yeah, I mean, the hidden for France makes a bunch of sense. No overmodding, it's grand finals. Overmodding could win you, but it could also cost you. And I mean, there's not really need to take the risk right now, I don't think. Even though you're behind as France, I think it's still fine. But I mean, we got Mize. We got Draxarda and we got Nuage on the hidden, Biotic on the hard rock, and then of course your two people that are perma lobby, I think, at this point, going the hidden, and then we got the gamers on the bottom going hard rock.
Mm-hmm.
And I think something to note here is, first of all, what is going on with Netherlands? Second of all, we have not seen what is going on with Netherlands. They're absolutely trolling this right now.
That section's like deceptively hard. Also, we just saw three breaks from France, two more breaks from France. So it's just 1 FC to 1 right now. That reading section can definitely trip you up on both mods.
I'm just mostly surprised to see Celine miss there, but we're seeing a bunch of misses, and it is dead even right now.
Well, break from Biotic, that was one of the FCs. That was the last FC for France. It's just UC2 running away with the combo now.
Terribly ahead. UC2 misses! That's big for France, because everyone's hitting, with the exception of Nuage, everyone's hitting this on France.
Okay, this is not... That got under control really quick. That's really good news for France. We just need things to hold now.
The accuracy, though, is not making it go over just quite yet, but it eventually will. And, XD trading there. You know, that's not ideal, but Noir is trading with UC3, though, so it's fine. Any trade with Celine or UC2 is definitely a benefit for France. And, I mean, Mize is holding, and Droxar is coming up from the behind, supporting him. And we're about two-thirds of the way into the map, going to this next Ki here.
The misses just keep getting traded on both sides. It's like I see two names go red at the same time over and over again.
Yeah, I mean...
Oh, that's a big one for France, though.
Yeah, oh, Nuage, but Droxar is the only combo right now. But luckily, I say luckily, but UC2 is the only one to hold on Netherlands right now. So it's a 1v1, and honestly, I think I favor Netherlands in that trade.
Yeah, the combo lead is on the side of France, but it's so close, and yeah, they need to hold. That it's just, it's a 1v1, like you said. It's who breaks first, because that score lead can definitely go back.
Those misses, though, are not good from France. I mean, it is a 1v1, but I mean, their supporting combo is going to start to be relevant here sometime soon. And I mean, Biotic is struggling, unfortunately. Oh, and Droxar missing! Oh, it's gonna go back over, and with so little of the map left, I don't think France has any chance of taking this back.
Oh no.
And they had it. They just needed to hold on for just a little bit longer. And I mean, UC2. I mean, there's...
That's
heartbreaking. If this person gets hidden, then you just lose, is the conclusion. I mean, it's just kind of unfortunate. And France had everything going for them correct, and just handful of misses. Just made
that's
it.
Heartbreaking. And that's one so miss. Heartbreaking. One miss from UC2 on that map. Yeah, it's another good team score, but it's not good enough. It's just not even like. Even Celine was quietly getting a really good score, topped all four of France's players. My god. And they consolidate their point. It's a 4-2 lead.
Yeah, so France is in a really, really, really bad spot right now, because Netherlands is not the type of team that's just going to let you win their own picks. And France does not have their protect. This is one of the worst positions I think France could be in.
Yeah. How do you dig yourself out of this hole? Maybe something like, if you're really, really ready for something like Nomad 4, like if you're practiced and confident on it, I don't know how confident you can be on that type of map, but like,
I think that's risky.
That's so risky.
There's a few things that they could go into that I was thinking. I don't think Nomad 4 is necessarily the best pick anymore, considering how some of these maps have went. DT1, I think, would have been a really good pick, just because I think that's a map that UC2 struggles on, if they're even in at all. And Hard Rock. I feel like a lot of these Hard Rock maps are France favored, with the exception of Hard Rock 3. I think that favors Netherlands because they have someone named Olim on their team, and that just kind of is rough. But Hard Rock 2, I think this is a very good pick. I think we've seen Netherlands lose this a few times. Probably once.
Yeah, I forgot that this Hard Rock 2 is tech. So I like this pick. This is kind of the best of both worlds. I don't think it's... it's definitely not unlosable for France. They could find a way, but I like this pick. I think it covers a lot of skill sets that they have an advantage of, even if it is just a slight advantage.
And we are just going to say, or we're going to see the first time that Droxar is not going to be playing this, and UC6 will be playing for France, their number fourth player. It'll most likely be... we got Biotic, who I feel like could play this.
That was my guess. If I'm not mistaken, they're pretty good at precision, especially. I could be completely wrong, but... So, UC6, 4-2-3, the classic roster for the Netherlands. You're right, actually, sorry. UC6, subbing in for France.
I mean, these four players have... basically played everything. And we're actually, I forgot Dracula's was on this team. I don't know why, but yeah, Dracula's. Duh. Dracula's is a very good hard rock player.
Yeah, very true.
He's like their best hard rock player.
Very true.
And I mean, these four from Netherlands have definitely been showing up. And fortunately, no one else on Netherlands is being able to get their time to shine. UC7 has not been in yet. I don't think UC1 has also played a map yet. And then I think UC8 has played one map. So we... Something I just realized. We have not seen Jacko.
We have not seen Jacko.
Imagine if Jacko was playing some of these hidden maps.
You know, we haven't seen Oob either. You see one.
Yes.
Have we?
We have not seen UC7, which is Nibble, and we also have not seen Oob, which is UC1.
Gotcha.
And a Twitch chat is telling me that UC1 has just gotten home.
Oh, okay.
So
Jacko is sleeping.
Jacko is sleeping. Alrighty.
This is a great time for both.
I think that benefits Netherlands, though, if I'm being honest, because Jacko is very good at hidden.
Yeah,
and
probably.
Probably needed him. And we're getting straight into it. We got some really funky sliders, and everyone's missing, so let's wait for a second so these combos get situated. And,
short map, though. Very short map.
It is a short map, so you gotta be careful with these misses. Dracul's missing Othman and Q-Mania holding, but I mean, UC2 and UC3, they're not the greatest at hard rock. This is, I think, one of their worst skill sets. So.
Yeah. But look at that, their team's got their back right now. They're keeping this lead really, really close. Both of their supporting combos for the last few maps are now the only full combos left in the lobby. Except for UC4, but still very, very good starting combo. We're at the halfway point of the map already.
Ooh, there's a bunch of misses from Netherlands. So UC6 or Unveiled Golem is the best hard rock player on Netherlands. Honestly think that probably better than Celine, at least better than UC2. I mean, we're seeing Dracul's kind of go on mode now, so it's not mattering so far, though. I mean, there's definitely some combo on Netherlands, but I mean, it's gonna go down shortly. We need France to hold, and they keep missing. And I mean, it's slowly creeping, and it goes over, and we need to see some misses. The map's almost over. And
there's one from UC4.
It's from Netherlands, and Dracul's is still holding. He's hitting everything right now.
He hit that space pattern and did it.
I think that's it. There's not enough combo left. He did it. And Dracul's putting the team on their back right there, and that is exactly what you want to see from France. That is perfect. Look at the scores from UC2 and UC3. That is what you want to see. You do not want to see anything over 500. And then look at France. You see Dracul's 650. That is, you know, not an FC. You don't need an FC.
What happened to the storyline? This flipped. Now it was like a Netherlands team score, and then Dracul's just carried France.
Exactly.
This is awesome.
It is what they need.
Interesting.
But
okay,
I mean,
so the bleeding has been stopped for now. The bleeding has been stopped. They got their point. They don't drop another break, but they are still down in tempo. They're still down one pick and one point. So they're not out of the woods yet, but that definitely helps them a lot. That's a really, really nice score, both for their mental and for the match itself.
Yeah, I mean, that's definitely... I don't know. It's hard, because on one hand, France did win that. On the other hand, they didn't win it that convincingly. And on another hand, they're still down a break point. So it is super, like, it's still not looking great for France until they get that whole break point situated, and they need to do it ASAP.
But it's a start. It's a start. That's all they need.
Yeah. We're going to need to see them take this next pick or the next, because I think if they don't, then I think it might be game over for France.
Yeah, well, I mean, you can tell they're not giving up.
Not at all. They've got some fighting spirits. They've got some fighting spirit.
Yeah.
For sure. I'm not calling it. I'm not calling it. Yeah. I'm just, you know, they're gonna have to make stuff happen. But Fremont 2,
There it is. Okay. Yeah, I think this is a good pick for Netherlands. After watching the Fremont one, I mean, the Fremont one was really close, but I don't know if I favor France on this one either.
No, not in particular. I think Fremont 3, I think France has this pretty good chance of taking, but we're just going to see a UC2. UC2 is probably going to FC this. Mm-hmm. Celine is also going to go. And then we're just going to see XD and Unveiled Golem slam the Hard Rock.
Yep. Are we seeing Easy? I don't think we're seeing Easy in this match, right? This is definitely a map that's easyable. Like, this is absolutely easyable.
We're definitely not seeing on Netherlands, unless you're France. I don't see, like, I don't know. When I think of France, I don't think of any easy players.
Yeah, I don't really either. I could be missing someone, but I don't usually know of easy players on that roster. I mean, hey, we can dream. I'd love to see it. Got to see it in the show match, since I have to bring up that show match again.
But, I mean, we have Nuage, Qmania going to be slamming the Hidden. Draxarta will also be going to Hidden, so they're going to need to grab a Hard Rock player. I assume it's probably going to be Dracul's coming back in. After doing that well on the Hard Rock 2, you can't just not play the Fremont 2.
Yep, very true.
Yep, there he is.
I'm hoping that they will be able to ride the high of that Hard Rock 2 performance. Because I want to see a tiebreak.
Yeah, it would be very good.
Yeah. They proved that they have no problems on the CS 6.5. So, let's see it again, yeah?
Yeah, I mean, Dracul is a very, very good Hard Rock player. I think what's going to happen is I think UC2 will FC, and then I think Dracul's is going to need a match Unveiled Golem.
Is the client broken, or are there only two mods on... Oh, yeah, okay. Dracul's is on Hard Rock. Dracul's is on Hard Rock. Okay, we're good. We're good.
Yeah, the client's broken. A little client, and we'll just think Dracul's missed. I don't know if that's real or not. And, I mean, basically everyone on Netherlands holding through this first section. But we do see XD and Unveiled Golem missing. Traded by Nuage, though. And Qmania actually is going the Nomad. And Draxarta is actually going the Hidden Hard Rock, so Qmania can go the Nomad. And, I mean, France has the slightest lead tonight right now. Ooh, that's not that great. We see Celine missing. And, I mean, France has a pretty early lead going into the halfway point.
There's one FC in the lobby and it's Hidden Hard Rock. Go off. Let's go.
Yeah. I mean, I don't. UC2 and Celine are not having the best of performances on this map. Celine is missing a bunch. And, I mean, this is all France right now. This is really good for them. And especially, like, Qmania holding on the snow mod is doing wonders for them. And, I mean, just look at the combos on France right now. Nuage about a 400, Draxarta 600 or 550 combo.
Oh my god.
Qmania 300. Dracul's is actually matching Unveiled Golem right now. So actually that works out perfectly. It is a 600,000 score lead and the map is over. There's only 200 combo left and I don't think that can make up 600k score.
Yeah, one break from Qmania here at the end will not mean anything. Even that break from Drax will not. It's 600k score. What a crazy team play. This is exactly what France needed to get back into the match. Yeah.
A great point. When Qmania actually hit that little stream there. And Nuage actually hit it too. That's actually insane from Nuage.
On Hidden, that's crazy. Yeah. That's a really crazy score. Top score in the lobby. Only four misses.
We see two players on France beating out UC2 and Celine. And we see Qmania beating out Celine. That was not close.
No. It feels like a mispick. Like, I can't even... It's crazy to call it that because, I mean, it's not... I think it was just maybe an unlucky, like, roll for the Netherlands score-wise, but Even if they had high rolled, I don't know if that would have been enough. France seemed really comfortable on that map.
Yeah, that was, I wouldn't say it's a mispick because we know what Netherlands is capable of. I just think they had some really unlucky rolls.
Yeah.
And especially, I mean, the outlier here, I mean, UC2 and Celine just did not put, I mean, I said they didn't play well. They played really well, but they didn't play up to their standards. And you know, I mean, that mattered.
I wonder if it's like a tempo issue because a lot of the maps in this pool are really high energy. Lots of movement involved in them for both hands. Like, that Fremont 2 is, it's got a lot of really crazy aim and reading, but the tapping side is not as intense. And sometimes if you're not warmed up for the lower intensity level maps, you're not going to be quite as prepared on the day of. So I'm wondering if that is coming into play at all. It's hard to find the reason why those scores were low, but I'm not sure.
Nuage trying to use Bathbot in multiplayer chat. I'm not sure what that's about, but
it's a flex. It's got to be a flex.
I guess. And all I've got to say is, you go. Like,
I respect it.
And okay, France is standing with the strategy, and I absolutely love it.
Yeah, I do too. I do too, especially after that performance that they just had. On an aim-focused map.
Their Hard Rock players for France have been playing really well. Drackle's on the Hard Rock too. And,
I was gonna... Like, this Hard Rock 1 is one of the maps in the pool that requires a pop-off performance. But a pop-off performance is a lot more likely on France for this style of map, I think, based on the two carries from Netherlands and their skill sets.
I think I'm going to say it, and this is going to be a really bold claim.
Boy.
I think that UC2 and Celine might be skill capped on this map just a tad bit.
I agree.
Just because of what kind of map this is. If it was just aim, I'd be like, whatever. But this is very tapping oriented with very aim oriented. So, you know, there is, you know, a bit of thing there. And we're not going to see Druxarda playing this, which... I think makes a little bit of sense. That might be a little bit too much for them, but I mean, we got Mize, Q-Mania, Offlund, and Drackles, you know, the very absolute god squad of Hard Rock gamers right there that you have.
Yeah.
And, I mean...
Which, and you talk about them being outscaled. I think it's funny that they're outscaled is probably still going to be like 300 to 400k.
Yeah.
But like, does France have someone that will be able to make up for that scaling on their own team? Because the map is just crazy hard for everyone. So if some of their supporting scores aren't as comfortable, they're going to need someone to push 500k plus in order to take those quote-unquote low skill caps. Because they are, but they don't. The scores don't look them. That's for sure.
I think we're probably going to see a pop-off performance from Unveiled Golem. And I want to see... Offman do really well. I think he could do really well on this map with a bunch of the France, but I think it's going to be the same story where France just consistently gets, you know, the same scores each other, and then we'll see if that's enough to beat the Netherlands players.
Yeah, UC2 already struggling to adjust to that AR10, I think, after playing that last map. But... four breaks, actually. I was going to just say the two on the side of France, but we do see the two players on the bottom half of Netherlands break early on in this map.
Yeah, I mean, France is struggling right now, and I mean, UC2 and Celine, I mean, they're playing the map. Oh, what was that? UC2, kind of, I don't know what that was for UC2,
that was
but
weird.
Ends up, yeah, missing.
That looked like tablet lag.
Yeah. And which is good for France, but I mean, Celine is. I guess Celine doesn't have a skill cap. I guess.
Yeah, I think we were just tripping.
That was a.
Yeah.
I said it was a bold statement, which I mean, it was a bold statement, but yeah.
Yeah. I don't know. There's no combo stabilizing outside of Affman and Drackles, so. It's Celine does find a break though. Okay, Now we've got a map on our hands, finally.
Yeah, Dracul's and Offman do have a big combo right there, and it's not really being matched on the other side, but we're seeing misses everywhere right now, and I mean, and they miss on that little space stream right there. But, and of course, the two powerhouses on Netherlands end up hitting the stream. So it will not go over to France, and now they have to hope for another miss from both of those players.
Yeah. Score lead growing. These misses that France keep finding are not helping at all. But there we go. Two more misses from those two players on the Netherlands.
Yeah, and Offman's holding now. A tad bit of combo, and as I say that.
Wow.
And, yeah, this map is...
That is messed up.
It's
yeah.
the hardest map in the pool. I think I can confidently say that.
By far.
I think Hidden 3 is probably the second hardest, but yeah.
This is the map that they're like, well, it's grand finals. Let's just pull it anyway. It's that kind of vibe. Yeah, I'm here for it. I like that. 75k the score gap going into the last third of the map.
Yeah, they'll say it's only 75k. It's definitely doable. And I mean, we've seen Celine and UC2 miss a bunch, so we just have to. It's doable, but I mean,
it's
kind of a lie considering how many breaks everyone's had on this map. Oh, but Celine missing there, and Unveiled Gold missing. There's one. Everyone in France is holding real quick. Hold on, Dracul's missing, but there's still three combos. Humania missing, but there's still two. But UC2 is holding it, and Offman missing as well. It's so close. Mice has to hold, or UC2 needs to miss. I think both need to happen, actually.
Yeah.
Score lead's increasing.
What?
Oh, and Mice missing.
No, dude.
That's
it. UC2 hit that. No way. There's just no way.
Yeah. It's over. That is the end of this for France, I think.
Yeah. And that's another breakpoint. They dug themselves out of the hole that they found themselves in earlier, and they're right back in the hole. It's... Wow, what a crazy score from UC2, by the way.
Yeah.
Even with that break there at the end, pushing over 400k, the only player in the lobby to do so.
And that 40k score lead is very misleading.
Yeah.
It's now 60k, but yeah, that is very misleading. That's map...
wild.
Yeah, I think I'm going to go out on a limb here and say this should be in a pool like two star ranks higher. Yeah, this map is just one of those that 400k is absolutely insane.
Yep, that's a crazy score from UC2 and Celine. Very, very nice. Sorry we doubted you. We apologize. You are not skill capped on the Hard Rock one, I promise. So let's now let's see if they consolidate that breakpoint right back. It's what we saw the last time, but
yeah.
I don't even think they could let the consolidation happen. Like, putting Netherlands on match point with two maps to go, like, after that match point would be pretty, pretty hard to hold on to, but let's see.
What
are they gonna pick?
This is really weird for the Netherlands, because I think the last of the maps aren't particularly anyone favored. I think Freebot 3 could go either way, just because of the nature of the map it is. But I do think it could also be a good pick for Netherlands, just because it's like super gimmicky.
Mm-hmm.
And I know Tykeny is watching, or not Tykeny, I know Gordon is watching this, hoping that it gets picked.
I do still think it'll get picked, and Netherlands has picked the other two free mods, so it looks like it's probably going to be them if they do decide to pick it. But maybe they're scared off after free mod 2? I don't know. Free mod 2 and free mod 3, I don't even know if they could be more different. They're so not the same map. It's crazy. I really want to see free mod 3. I don't even know if it's a good pick necessarily. I just want to see it played. I want to see the practice gap between the players who play this map 40 times in the last week and the players who played it twice.
I did not expect this at all.
Yeah, that's out of nowhere.
This is a France pick.
That's like some script stuff. Like, that's some... There's a tiebreaker on the script. We gotta match the script kind of stuff.
I...
What? That's...
Yeah, this is...
is it a panic Whoa. Pick since it came in at the last second? Maybe two people said it. Maybe it's there's.
I wouldn't even say it's a panic pick, because you'd think if they like panic pick something, it would have been like 3-on-3, right?
Yeah.
Which.
Who knows?
There's some questions there, but.
Because this is the like UC2's not in on this, right?
Right? I don't know. UC2, it's not a UC2 map, but UC2 might play it.
Oob is here.
Oob is in the lobby, ladies and gentlemen.
Okay. Even with Oob here, like, is that good enough of a reason to pick DT1?
Not at all. But there's probably a reason they picked this. It could have been a panic pick. Just from the rosters and how these teams have performed on DT1s in the past.
I don't know what this pick, but we don't know
the team scores, so.
We doubted them on Hard Rock 1, even though, I mean, it wasn't their pick, but we doubted those two players on Hard Rock 1. I doubted the Hidden 3. I did some doubting on the Nomad 3. Like, I'm not doubting this Netherlands team anymore. They know what they're doing. They picked DT1. I'm sure they're prepared for DT1.
Oob is not in the lobby anymore.
Okay, there he goes.
Oob was there to give some wise words to Twitch chat and then left.
Yeah.
And
oh, he's back.
Oob is... No, is he? Oh, yeah,
he's in the lobby.
Okay.
He's probably gone again.
I was about to say, I don't think he's playing.
We do still need a fourth for France. It's New Age. Okay.
It's in...
Sorry, New Age.
And, I mean... Netherlands has just been running with this four, and it's been working. Why would you switch?
Yeah. Okay, we get to see UC2 on DT1. I'm intrigued. It'll be
similar to the DT3 in terms of accuracy. I mean, I have no question about these players combo gaming anything. It's more along the lines of accuracy, which... It doesn't matter anymore. I just don't care. It doesn't matter.
Yeah, I'm just going to sit back and watch the show because I don't know what to think about this pick. Maybe it's just a Celine angle. Who knows?
I mean, there's Unveiled Golem. It was forced to play DT1. It looks like.
Yeah. Maybe it's just the trying to shake off the start of the map kind of thing. Hopefully, we'll see. No major combo breaks just yet.
Hoffman actually almost broke there, and actually Celine is like the first significant miss. Crazy that I would ever say that, but
yeah. What were they cooking? What were they cooking? Let's see. Maybe there's a diss. Oh, okay.
There's kind of things that happen. Drackle's off one and UC2 missing, but Maya's a new watch holding.
That favors the Netherlands because they only had one drop, and we're not at the halfway point yet.
Yeah, just favors them a tad bit. But I mean, France has been looking super comfortable on this map, and they really only broke because it was a bit of a diff spike. They've looked pretty comfortable on the rest of this map, and Celine and XD missing, traded by nobody on the side of France.
Yeah, that was one of their full combos.
Oh, the Mize. That's a pretty big miss, but Nuage is still holding.
Yeah, it's Nuage versus Unveiled Golem right now. It's a 1v1. The supporting combos are actually favoring France as well. 2 300s, two more breaks. Netherlands just collapsed.
The
Netherlands just had a full team miss, and this map is over.
Drackle's missing there as well, helping out Netherlands just a tad bit, but Nuage holding and not holding any longer, unfortunately. It is a 300,000 score lead, though, and there's just no combo anywhere.
Okay. Is there time? I don't know if there's time.
I don't know what the max combo is on this map.
Lack of density.
Come down to the wire if there is time, but with everyone missing on Netherlands, there's no time anymore. It is Jober, as one might say.
Oh my gosh, back breakpoints.
And I mean, we talked about, you know, how you know, this is something that France should pick, and that, you know, I mean, Netherlands is pretty weak at, well, considering. And I mean, look at France's scores, 500, 500, 700, 400. And then you look over on the other side, 440, 400, 450, 440. I mean, it's just,
I mean, yeah, this just seems like France, like the Netherlands had a good team score, but it, I don't think that they had the possibility to have one person pop off in this map as much as France did. And yes, France got their pop off. Nuage got their 700K. And that was the score gap. That was it.
So, even if Nuage got a 500K like the rest of them, they still would have won.
That is true, yeah.
So it's not even like, I mean, Nuage definitely popped off more than anybody else. But at the end of the day, like, I mean, even if it was even team scores, I don't know. I'm questioning that pick. But, I mean, it doesn't really matter. It's even now. I don't know what's going on anymore. I need an adult.
They were just following the, they were following the script, right? Because the script said that in order for them to win, they had to pick DT1. It just
I thought Stage got mad at me the last time I mentioned it, so I thought I wasn't allowed to mention it.
Oh, that's he's gonna come for me now.
Yeah, he might join VC and start yelling at you.
Oh no! Oh god! Stage is scary when he's angry. It's a joke. I swear,
A joke. Look, he's got mental bruises from the last time. But whose pick is it? France? I have no idea.
I don't either.
DT4, maybe? But I think that's one of those maps where it's a pop-off to win the map, so I don't know.
Yeah.
Oh, this is so hard. Maybe Nomad 1, I think, is a bad pick. I think we can chalk that up to that.
Yeah.
I think Nomad 4 is a toss-up. Hiddens are gone. Hard Rock 3, I don't think there's any France
pick. There's no way they pick Hard Rock 3. Okay, it's Fremont 3.
Yeah, which I actually don't mind from France.
This is, I think, probably one of their better picks that's left in the pool.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, I don't know. And then if I had to guess, maybe the Netherlands go with Hard Rock 3 last, maybe Nomad 1.
They could go Nomad 1. I think Nomad 1 would be a good pick for them. But it's also one of those picks where they could also just lose them. So
yeah, I mean, yeah, we're at the stage of the match where no one is, everyone's scared to pick because none of these are like, oh yeah, we got this, easy.
You mispick right now and you lose, you would get eliminated from the tournament, basically. And I think this is my take on this. I think if France win this, it's going to tiebreaker. I think if France loses this, then they lose the match.
I agree, yeah. Because, I mean, obviously they could just break point if they do lose this, but I definitely favor Netherlands on the back half or the back part of this pool.
Yeah.
Just because of those two players, UC2 and Celine. We should have a counter for how many times we've said their names this match.
It'll probably be in the Mr. No Life video.
Yeah, probably.
But I mean, they've got to be feeling the pressure right now for sure. I mean, there's just UC2 and UC3 or Celine, just they don't care. They absolutely don't care.
Mods.
That
Dracul's Hard Rock, right? We got that one. We got Mai's hidden. UC2 hidden?
UC2 and Celine are probably going hidden.
Or do you think
there's an overmod, I think, for France. I think Draxarda might go hidden Hard Rock and Mai's might go the no mod.
Okay. I was gonna say maybe we also see a hidden Hard Rock on the Netherlands, so that way someone like UC2 or Celine could go Nomad. Cause like it's not easy on Nomad, but it's definitely easier than hidden and Hard Rock for sure.
The only problem I see with that is the person who would most likely be going the hidden Hard Rock would be Unveiled Golem for Celine.
Mm-hmm.
And I think Unveiled Golem score will drop a lot if that's the case. So it's like the score will drop a lot. How much will Celine's score get better? Will it make up the difference? Will it be worth it?
Yeah, that's when you get to this stage in a tournament, that's always the question to ask. Is throwing one mod worth the no mod score that someone else will get? And a lot of times it is worth it, but it depends on the comfort of those high level players on the Netherlands right now.
And we'll see. And we are correct on France and Overmod from Netherlands. So, I mean, that makes sense.
Yeah, I definitely agree. It's not like Celine's not comfortable on Hidden. The question is, how much do these players practice this map? That's what's going to matter.
Oh, my lord. Everyone died.
Yeah, this, they, I expect 80%.
Yeah, for no one the better part of the 90. Map.
Well, I don't know about that. I don't know if I'd go that far, but...
I don't know.
It's going to take some time to get the act back to back above 90 for sure.
But, I mean, the player to watch out for, I think, is definitely going to be Mize on France, and then I think it's going to be Celine. I think Celine will do a tad bit better on these maps than UC2, and we're seeing a bunch of misses from the supporting characters right now, from Nuage, UC4, and UC6. And I mean, France has definitely got the combo lead right now. It's the first third of the map, so there's a bunch of time left.
They have a pretty big ACK lead just because of Golem's struggle with Hard Rock right now as well. The aim is gonna start to get a little trickier in this middle section of the map. So we'll see if we get any misses. Two breaks, one on each side.
Draxarda missing, and it's being traded by the supports on Netherlands, but they need one of the big boys to miss, and they're missing right now. But Drakkles is still holding.
Two more breaks from France.
Yeah, but it's got a pretty... It's going to go down, but with Drakkles holding, it's going to mitigate how fast that goes down. Maybe enough for France to rebuild the combo, and... I mean, Drakkles. Misses. Oh, this is kind of.
Celine.
They're good. Yeah, Celine and UC2 are holding, and this is where. Oh, it's a Bancho miss from Drakkles.
Oh, it was Bancho. Oh my God! Wait a second.
They need some. So they need some help from France. All of France needs to hold, and there's. It's not that combo dense. So that's 150 score lead. Drakkles misses.
Is that
I think
real?
That might have been a real miss. Oh, be careful. Mize and Nuage have some 400 combo, but
Just UC2.
Oh, 70K. But it's still going down just a tad bit. The map needs to end soon for France. And Nuage needs to...
I don't think the slider mattered, but oh my God. That is a nail biter. We've got one more section right here at the end. Chain misses? No chain misses.
France taking Fremont 3 by the backpack of Drakkles. I mean, Celine and UC2 just absolutely went mode, but this is what we were talking about with Netherlands and the problem. I mean, XD and Unveiled Golem just
Wait a second. Hidden Hard Rock multiplier. Wait a second. It's not over yet. We actually need to do math, because Hidden Hard Rock does not give a score buff in our scoring system.
I forgot about that. Oh, there's no hit. What? We're being told that there's no Hidden Hard Rock multiplier. You trolled me.
That's the point. Like, we have to subtract score.
Oh, what the...
Right? Am I tripping?
I think you're tripping.
No, I'm tripping. Don't worry about me.
Why I was so confused.
Dude, I got so scared. I saw chat say wait a bunch and say hidden Hard Rock, and I was like, oh, wait a second.
Yeah, hold on. You were like baiting me. I'm pretty sure you just like...
Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. It's fine. Everything's fine, guys. It's fine. Don't worry about it.
But yeah, I mean... buddy, we might see the tiebreaker. And I would love to see tiebreaker.
God, yeah. We're on track, I think. I'm pretty sure we are on track for that. Oh my God. Okay, so what is it now? Is it Nomad 1? Is it...
I think there's... Honestly, I don't think it might... I don't know. This hurts. Okay, so I think Nomad 4 is a big toss-up, and I think either one of these teams could win it. I don't see Netherlands necessarily picking that map. DT4, I think that is a pretty pop-off heavy map. I could see Netherlands picking it. And then Nomad 1. Hard Rock 3. I think it could be Hard Rock 3. I think that would be a pretty...
Do you think those are their best picks?
I don't think they have any best picks anymore.
No, I
think
mean out of what's left. Out of what's left.
It is so hard to say. I think every... I don't know. I would say Horcrux 3 either. Out of everything is they're probably their best
but
pick.
Do you do that after Dracul's just did that on what was basically a Hard Rock 3?
I mean... like. I mean, that's kind of the worry with a lot of these things, right? I mean, Nomad 1 has that potential for everybody, though. It's the problem with Nomad 1. I mean,
yeah.
I think UC2, and I don't think it's hard enough map. So I don't think they can, them alone can win that. As for Nomad 4, that could be a pop-up potential, but I think it's one of those maps where it's super shit missable. And I don't think that... that's something that UC2 and Celine can necessarily avoid. I think that is definitely a possibility.
Yeah. Okay.
And they actually do. I'm surprised about this pick. I'm not saying it's bad, but I'm surprised.
I do think it's better than Hard Rock. Just because, like, they have a less comfortable overall Hard Rock roster compared to France. Not by much, but by a little bit. And while the, like, pop-off is there... for people like Celine and UC6, like, I just don't know if it beats France's consistent score on, like, a Hard Rock 3. And Nomad 1, there's no, all bets are off. Like,
we could see
800-600Ks, we could see 1-9, like, FC, I don't know, like, it's,
yeah,
who knows
I get it. My reasoning was, so Unveiled Golem 3-3, that's not the kind of map that they would really be playing. They absolutely beast mode this. I think they could have beast moded this Hard Rock 3. Mm-hmm. And then UC2 and Celine just kind of do their thing. And I think, honestly, it could have happened. Obviously, there's kind of the RNG factor in, but I mean, we picked Nomad 1, so I think we can throw that out the window.
Yeah.
Because this is a map where I think everybody is going to be super, like, I think all the scores are going to be very similar. I think we'll see like 400k average on this map. I don't either. Really see, there will probably be an FC or two. I could definitely see that. I think this is definitely one of the easier maps in the pool for sure.
Yeah, it's easier, but I'd still be surprised if there was an FC, because I don't really like, I don't know.
Rough.
Is this Biotic's first map?
Hold on. Biotic played Hard Rock 2. Not played Hard Rock 2. Okay. Biotic played 3-mod 1.
Okay, gotcha, gotcha.
I think that was it.
Wow, okay.
I also am getting the MP link, and we'll see. Biotic. Played Nomad 2.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
I forgot about that.
That map feels like years ago at this point.
It basically was. And, 3-mod 1 and Nomad 2 is the only two maps that he's played.
Gotcha.
And now we'll get into No Modular 1.
Man, and same roster for the Netherlands again.
Who needs more people? I mean, who needs them?
It must be like a scaling thing. I don't know, maybe they don't have people here, but like, scaling is probably what it is, because we are at the top end of 5-digit. Like, you won't see harder 5-digit pools, at least not logical ones, I guess, but... okay, Nomad 1. This is to tie the match at 6-all and send us to our custom tiebreaker. I'm so excited.
Or potentially Nomad 1 just runs away with this.
Yeah, we'll see. We shall see.
Yeah.
Buckle up, boys.
And we don't see any misses in the first half of this map, or the first section of this map, like we did in the show match. Shout out to show match. Go watch that. But
I'm on the edge of my seat. Nothing has happened yet because hasn't picked up yet. But I'm still like, I'm ready. This first Ki is going to matter a lot.
Yeah. Honestly, I'll be surprised to see if anyone hits it, but for an Unveiled Golem right before the Ki, that's not the greatest, but Ki is right here, so we'll see how many misses we see on France in return. And so far, it's not looking like any of them. But my first one, UC4 trading it though, so it's fine.
Okay. this is looking good for France so far. If they can make it out of the Ski Eye completely with those three FCs intact, they are looking good for quite a while.
Yeah, and we had three people in France hold to the entire Ki Eye, and five people in the entire match holding the Ki Eye, which is kind of crazy, but... And then, I mean, just the accuracy is very comfortable. Oh, Alphaboon trading with Celine, though, so it's fine. That benefits France. Any miss you can get on those two players is good.
Oh, gosh. Yeah, that is true. That's very true.
But, I mean, XD is kind of recovering a little bit. But, I mean, Draxarta and Biotic still holding the aim players for this team, you know, putting in work.
Boy, the UC2 shake is happening too. I've seen it a couple times. This is not hidden three. You don't want to shake on this one. Another break from Netherlands. Another two breaks, actually.
Yeah, the second Ki. And, Biotic missing. Biotic. Which is not ideal, but I mean, Draxarta is still matching UC2 right now. And Celine trading again, so even.
It's just the big combos.
Yeah, I mean, Offman has a bit of support with that 300 combo, but I mean, Draxarta versus UC2 right now, and we need to see both of them hold for their respective teams. Actually for Netherlands, you need Draxarta to miss.
Yeah, this is starting to get close to over, actually. We've got one third of the map left. A stream, both players hit it.
There's a really funky stream here, I believe, and but Draxarta can't hit it. It's 200k.
No way. He slow slidered. Are you kidding?
Oh, that is absolutely detrimental. That honestly might spell the end for Netherlands.
200k and no combo.
There's no combo. Oh, I think that's it. There's some map left, but it's not that combo dense. And there's
some chain misses. I don't know. 250 is a lot.
I think it's over. I think this is GG.
One more ending jump section.
Yeah, it's over. There's not enough there's not enough map left, and there's not enough combo on the side of Netherlands for it to matter. And despite all odds, France has Netherlands number, not beating them once, but beating them twice. GG's France, you played out of your mind. Unfortunately, these five digits will never have to deal with UC2 or Celine for the next 5 years at the least. And they are officially done with five digit tournaments. And because France wins, the final match of the five-digit United States World Cup will be tomorrow.
Oh my gosh, an S rank. One slider break on the Nomad 1. When do you see that happen?
That made the difference. That's the difference. One slider break lost them the map, unfortunately.
Oh my god. Wow. Congratulations to France. Things were looking so scary at the start of that match, but they brought it all the way back. All the way back from the depths. 7-5. Looks like we are going to see tiebreaker for fun. My god, that is incredible. Taking out the number one seed twice in this tournament.
France letting people know that it was not a fluke. And that they definitely deserve to be, you know, in the grand finals going against Russia, against their arch nemesis. When I think of two teams that have each other's numbers, I don't know why, but I just... France and Russia are always those two teams that I think of that are super competitive against each other. It's always.
Mm-hmm.
Always winning against each other, and I'd love to see it. I could not think of a better grand finals match than France and Russia.
And yeah, we are going to get to see a repeat of winners finals.
We will.
That's crazy. This was such a hype match to watch. I'm glad we are going to get to see the tiebreaker as well.
Yeah.
My god, that's so crazy. I didn't expect that to happen, but France closed it out cleanly on the Nomad 1, breaking that point. Wow. Congratulations to them. Netherlands, unfortunately, going to be finishing in third place in 5WC 2023. Still a really, really great performance from them. especially after last year. Quite an upgrade from 13th, I think, to 3rd. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. What a match.
So, I don't know if I said this on stream, but the badge situation for UC2 and Celine. UC2 has, I believe, 3 badges at 15k, and I believe that makes you rank somewhere around 5k, right? Celine has 6 badges as a 30k at 4k. I did the math roughly. For Celine to be able to play 5-digit tournaments, Celine needs to be like 75k.
Yeah.
So we're good for a while, guys. Don't worry.
I don't know if UC2 is 9K.
So UC2 might be able to smurf some more 5-digit tournaments, but we're not going to see Celine for quite a while.
Yeah. But still, I think strong performance. Strong performance overall throughout the tournament. Definitely something to be proud of. Because in a country-based tournament, it's really, really hard to see big jumps like that in terms of like overall placement. So they should feel very proud of themselves for getting this far. And I'm sure France is elated to have another chance to get the run back against Russia, yeah. Excited to see this tiebreaker too, because now we would have, I don't know if the teams are going to be full tryharding, but it'll be cool to see.
I think that this is going to be an absolute stomp from UC2 and Celine.
It looks like
they might have
uneven teams, but oh well.
Yeah, France probably is super nervous, just probably. Also, fun fact, Jacko did not play this match for France, yeah. And that is huge for France that they were able to beat Netherlands without like one of their best hidden players.
Yeah,
and gimmick players. That's probably why you see like the Nomad 6 ban, the Hidden 2 ban. Like, but I mean, and they have 600k score already. Very impressive for the side of France.
Yeah,
don't know why the client is doing that. I've never seen that.
It's
before.
Just being silly.
I've seen it do that at the beginning and adjust itself, but I've never seen it not adjust itself.
Yeah, it's funny.
And UC2 going hidden. Oh, Lord.
It's a comfort thing. This map is...
for sure it's a comfort thing.
Yeah. Man, we get to see this thing 2 times today. What a treat.
My voice is shot. I have commentated 4 hours of 5WC. I started at 1 o'clock. It is now 5 o'clock. I am dying. My voice hurts. I want to go get drunk because it's my birthday.
Oh, happy birthday. Are you turning 21?
No, I'm turning 22, but I still want to get drunk.
Oh, okay. That's still a good reason. That's a good reason. Happy birthday from the chat. Wow.
I know. Thank you, guys. Oh.
This song is so cool. I hope to God we get to see this.
It'd be cool.
Like actually played. Oh, yeah. And ranked too. Yeah. I mean, I want to see this thing destroyed by top
UC2
players as well.
UC2 is absolutely mashing through everything, as in particular UC2 fashion.
Hey, 900 combo. What the heck?
You stop.
Yo, do it. Come on. Combo through it.
Stop it. Stop doing it. It's
easy. Okay. Finally. Yo, people are sleeping on the hard style section too. I think it's kind of fire.
Yeah, this map's super funky. I like funky. Funky map's cool.
Yeah.
Who would have played this for France, the fourth player? Like, would the players have actually played this? Mize probably would have played it.
Yeah, Mize.
We only saw Cumania once, and I don't know why. I feel like.
It's probably Cumania just because skill cap, I guess, but like,
maybe.
I don't really know. This is, I'm not sure.
I don't know, but doesn't matter. EC2 just... Yep. And Celine is now backing up. These are some super difficult patterns.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we said this before. I think this. I think if it goes to tiebreaker, France loses.
Yeah. The down person, but I don't think that person would have 150k.
Hey, I stick with that claim that France would have lost this tiebreaker if they won against Russia. That's a different story. I think either of those teams could win. But
yeah, I think the Russia one's a lot more even. I hope we get to see it for real. I really hope we get to see it for real.
That would be pretty cool.
Mm-hmm. What was the highest score we saw in the show match? I think it was Birchman with like a little over 300k, right? Or at least that we saw on stream.
So I was about to say the ones that we saw on stream. There's an MP link I'm actually gonna grab. I am in the show. I got the leaks. All right. Yeah. So, Stanall got 250. Oh my God, Birchman got 400k.
Stage just baited people into getting timed out.
yeah, Birchman got 366k. That's pretty good.
Yeah. You know, we say that, but I was going to say UC2's on track to beat that, but maybe not.
I mean, I feel like
okay,
UC2
wait a
could
second.
Still beat it. Oh,
Shall?
Actually, Druxarda.
I was
going to
say, bottom left, let's go. Almost 1k.
Bro, we got some down bad people in Twitch chat. What is going on?
Funny.
But, yeah, I mean, this is pretty impressive from a handful of these players.
You know, maybe
he's hitting these.
You know, maybe it like would have been a little closer because 150k at this point is like definitely.
Yeah, actually.
Okay. Interesting.
And I mean, Droxarda is playing really well on this map right now, and I think just now beat Birchman's combo on this map.
Yeah.
But the accuracy is, and here we go. We're getting into the breakdown section right here. Let's see. Oh my God, Droxarda, what are you doing?
Come on, man.
He's going mode right now. He hit that.
He is making Russia afraid of them.
Russia, do not go to tiebreaker. Do
Russia
not
does
go to
not
tiebreaker.
Want to go to tiebreaker anymore.
Yeah. Okay. So I still think it's super Netherlands favored. What with that pop off from Druxarda?
Yeah.
I mean, they definitely could have won this. And I mean, Druxarda, what the hell are you doing, man?
Yeah, that's crazy. And you know what's even crazier? UC2 still beat his score.
it's. Hidden.
Yeah.
That's all it comes down to is hidden. But I mean, I think we could have seen France actually win that. I mean, I don't know.
That would have been really hype to watch. That would have been really hype.
Stage was like, I placed these notes. Congrats, Stage. How many notes did you, was that? I don't know how many notes did you place? You placed like 4? Did you do that slider, Stage?
At least 5.
Who did the slider? I want to know who did the slider, because that's... Oh, Stage did the slider? Let's go. Let's go! Oh man. Well, thank you everyone for watching.
Once again, congrats to France.
Yep.
Well played, Netherlands.
Thank you, Luca.
Thank you very much, Spectre. It's been a pleasure as always casting with you.
And this is the last you'll see of us commentators, unfortunately. You can wish us goodbye. You'll never see us ever again.
Never again.
Tell us why we're your favorite commentators. And good luck to, I believe, Miles and Tykeny.
Use code 5WC.
Yep. And code 5UC. Hey, goodbye.